I'm so fucking stupid. I just bought this camera. I just bought the Canon G7X camera. And I'm recording on it right now. And it is a beautiful camera. I was looking up stuff on the internet. And every vlogger that I watch, especially David Dobrik, the reason why I got into vlogging is because of him, that he uses something called the Canon 80D. That is a huge camera. I was shocked. I was like, well, I didn't realize that he carries around this big ass thing with him every time he vlogs. He goes to parties and he's got this thing with him. And I was like, there's no way. There's no way in hell I would ever vlog with something like that. Yeah. I bought it.
Do you know what I've realized after making quite a few videos is that YouTube is a difficult job. It is difficult to try and find content that's worth putting into your videos. It really is. It's not an easy job. I thought it would be easy, but it's not. But it's interesting. It's interesting trying to find things to film because, I mean, in an everyday life, you've got work, I've got uni, work, you got a social life, you can't always film. It's very difficult trying to find things to film, and then of course it's trying to find people who are comfortable to be on camera for you to film anyway. Quite a lot of YouTubers before I got into this vlogging business, I took notes from David Dobrik, I took notes from Casey, right, and even from PewDiePie as well. Now, what I've realized is that all of them have got their own little market that they tailor their videos to. For example, David's videos are all about entertainment and he uses his friends to create the content. And then there, he's got content for his videos, right? Casey, on the other hand, is more like an everyday person. So yes, he's rich. Yes, he's got his own studio in fucking New York City so he can just go out and film and he's got content right there. And PewDiePie stays, you know, at home and makes videos on his computer. I mean, he's got an amazing commentary, you know. So I thought they all got their own individual markets, and there's so many YouTubers out there right now. So what exactly am I going to do to make me a bit different? Why not have a YouTube channel that is so diverse that your subscribers don't anticipate what's coming next? They don't think it's going to be an everyday vlog about a studio, or it's going to be with your friends going out partying, clubbing. It's not going to be about a gaming video. What if it's just a whole bunch of just absolute randomness? What if we decided to film in certain ways? So I already tried to film like David Dobrik when I had this video with Shubs' birthday in it. This one right here. Alright, go watch it, okay? So I already tried to be like David Dobrik, and I was like, yeah, this is fun and everything, but at the same time, you gotta have people who are comfortable being in front of a camera and being able to act like an idiot. Okay, not all my friends are gonna be on camera every single time because they've got their own shit that they need to do, so I'm not gonna always have content to make with them. Then I realized that Casey hardly ever has other people in his videos. It's mainly him just talking about certain subjects, and I thought that was amazing. I thought, yeah, I could possibly do that. So, how to be like Casey? Now I feel like Casey. Now I do. Oh, there he is. There he is. Hi, Dext. Hello. Hey, buddy. Hey. I just want to see how this looks. I can't even see. How can you see the screen without? I can't even see it. Like, the sun is in my eyes. This is winter in Australia. Can you believe that? It is quiet out today. It is really quiet. It's the middle of the day. People are very quiet. I see a few people walking around. This camera is heavy as shit. Oh my god. Damn, like, I go to the gym, but this is a whole nother workout in itself. Okay. I have come to the conclusion that filming like Casey is hard work. Okay, I mean, I thought if I put the sunglasses on and I just go walk outside, it was all gonna be easy. I was wrong. I feel like all my energy is drained because I'm using it to hold up this goddamn behemoth of a camera. I do have a smaller camera, which is the Canon G7 X Mark II, which is the one that I normally use when I go out. But I thought, hey, fuck it, let me just try with the Canon 80D because David uses it, Casey uses it, and I was like, fuck it, let me use it outside. God, those guys must have intense forearm strength. Like, damn. So, that was interesting. What I've realized is that, I've realized a couple of things. I'm unfit as a motherfucker, and I can't, I tried filming like Casey. I had the glasses on, I had everything going. Wow. And I just come to the conclusion that I can't film like Casey. I'm gonna have to make my own content. I could do daily vlogging, I could write skits, and I could play games at the same time. If we really break it down, okay? Is that my channel is going to have diversity. That is what I'm aiming for right now. Diversity over anything else. Yeah, I want to be in the food vloggings. I want to be in the normal vloggings. I want to be going on adventures, travel vlogs, everything. Parties, whatever it is. I want to be completely diverse so you have no idea what the next vlog is going to be. I've never actually sat down in front of a camera like this and talked. I haven't. So it's completely new to my channel, which is what I love, which is why I'm doing this. Look, I know it's a bit different to what I'm normally doing, but I hope you enjoyed it.